Now we have to build our light transmitter. It's going to take the electrical signal from the radio and turn it into a time-varying light signal. So here's the circuit diagram. We have the radio, and it has two leads coming from it. And let me show you that. So here's the radio, and here is, once again, the mono phono plug. It's got the one band on it. It will just work with anything you plug it into. So I'll plug that into the radio, and that goes to two leads, which will connect to the rest of our circuit. Now, in that circuit, there's going to be a 9-volt battery, which has a positive and a negative side, and a 470-ohm resistor. If I don't have that 470-ohm resistor, when I connect the 9-volt battery to my light-emitting diode, the light-emitting diode will burn out instantly. So we need that resistor. Now, the 9-volt battery snaps into this battery holder. And I use Velcro to hold it in place on my breadboard. And the battery holder is color-coded. The positive terminal of the battery goes into the red lead on the battery holder. So this red lead is the positive terminal, and it goes out and it connects to one side of the light-emitting diode. And the black lead goes to the other side of the light-emitting diode. Now, my switch is simply an alligator clip that I clip to a bent paper clip. And that's how I turn my light-emitting diode on and off. Now, there's a little bit of a trickiness about light-emitting diodes. A light-emitting diode has two legs to it, a long leg and a short leg. And the longer leg must be connected to the positive terminal of the battery to make the light-emitting diode glow. So when I mounted my light-emitting diode to my circuit, I made sure the longer leg went to the red lead on the battery. Now, what's going on here is that electrons are actually leaving the negative terminal of the battery, going through the black wire, going to the short lead of the light-emitting diode, and they come in with the full 9 volts, very high energy, and they drop their energy and turn it into light. And then the electrons with lower energy continue around back into the battery.